Hey everybody, it's JTB, and welcome back to The Run. This is chapter 12. This is a fairly straightforward chapter, actually. It's very combat-heavy, as I mentioned in chapter 11. It is a very combat-heavy chapter, but as long as you just kind of, you know, do what we've been doing throughout this run, you'll get it kind of no problem. I do lean on saves quite a bit in this chapter. As I said previously, you know, I'm kind of on a crunch here. I need to just kind of, I want to kind of just get this done. And then look into doing some other runs. So here, I've upgraded my pulse rifle, I believe, or I do that at the end. I can't quite. I think I do it at the end, actually. I have my loadout a little bit different here. So I've actually offloaded the Ripper. I think I did leave that in the video in Chapter 11. There's my memory being, you know, fantastic as always. Oh, it's my contact beam. That's right. So I fully upgraded the contact beam here. I only really do that because I've never really used the contact beam all that much, and I've heard that it is really, really good, so I wanted to give it a go here. I love the noise it makes. It has one of the best noises in the game. And then we're just going to kind of go all out here, really. I bought a lot of plasma cutter ammo. Really, I think you only need the plasma cutter here. If you really don't have to worry about plasma cutter ammo in this segment, you really can just kind of dump shots into stuff, and you really don't have to think all that much. What I like to do, though, is run along this left-hand side here. You'll have a guy spawn on your left through the vent, and there's a spawn point here on your right. Other than that, though, there's no other way the enemies can get to you. So this licker here will either spawn at the vent he spawned at, or he'll spawn on the left-hand side from where I am standing right now on the other platform. This triple tentacle guy is always there. He drops down the vent on the left, like up towards the left where that Stasis statue is. You'll get a big dude drop down here. I'm just kind of checking because I thought I heard something there on the right. And if you get really good spawns on this, you can actually use a lot of the spikes that enemies drop. So you can just pull off spikes constantly from bodies and, you know, shoot them like that. You've got a couple of armored guys to deal with. They're not, you know, too big of a problem. You can really lean on Stasis here. I love the animation there. Well, that got him in the head and he just kind of fell over. But yeah, the only thing you really want to keep an eye out for here, as you can see it here, this gets a little bit hairy because I've got guys in front, and now the guy on the right decides to spawn. Fortunately, it's a tentacle guy because, you know, they have a huge wind-up on their moves. So I can kill the guy that was up top and then, you know, the good old force gun to the rescue. If you ever get in kind of a, you know, a bit of a shaky spot, so to speak, you know, just whip out the force gun and just kind of shoot a couple of shots just to knock stuff over. Just kind of whipped out the contact beam here for funsies because I thought, why not? And here I can just, you know, hoover up all my items, which is nice. I love doing that. You know, after a fight like that, you just get a ton of items. So I've remembered to speed up. I've sped up actually quite a few segments in this chapter. Aside from the fighting, this chapter is a lot of, you know, Isaac standing around waiting for people to finish talking to him before you can carry on, which is a bit, annoying. Before speeding this up, I think this chapter was close to 40 minutes. There's a lot. There's a lot of walkie and talkie sections in this. Like, I mean, I guess, you know, that was kind of a thing for the time. For sure. So here I'm just going to put in a save. I basically just save whenever I get to, you know, a new save point. I wouldn't say you really need to. I just did it for, you know, ease of getting this run finished because I wanted to get it done. Here is one of the main reasons I have the flamethrower. These guys, they're not too difficult, all things considered, but it can get a little bit hairy if they retreat their tentacles and they keep spawning the single shot dudes. Fortunately, you can just double stasis and just alt fire with the flamethrower, and these guys are totally dead. I think late game, one level one flamethrower alt fire isn't a guaranteed kill on them, depending on what they do with their tentacles. If they really have their tentacles out a lot, then you'll still kill them. But if they can sometimes kind of retract them in, as you saw there. If you've got a couple of upgrades on, you know, the flamethrower, and you get, I think the special ability is, it, you know, your alt fire burns for a lot longer. As you can see there, even though they retreated their tentacles a couple of times, the alt fire was still going, so it still kills them. So this segment here, shoutouts to Justin in my chat, I think it was. Out of habit, I always used to shoot all the little pus balls to release everything. If you don't do that, you don't actually trigger all the fans to start moving, so it makes that a bit easier to go. This fight's probably the only thing you really need to worry about in this whole chapter, really. You've got a armored guy spawn, a liquor guy spawn, and a brute, and you've got a tentacle guy. The tentacle and the armored guy are definitely priority number one because, you know, the armored guy can, you know, not get stunned by leg shots, and the tentacle guy can shoot you. From there on, you just want to really abuse stasis. I've got tons of stasis packs here as well, so I don't really need to worry too much about, you know, how much I'm using stasis, but you really just want to keep note of where you're stepping here. There's a lot of the, you know, the dead floor, like the goo stuff lying around. I don't know what it's called, but there is a lot of that in this room. So you really want to give that a wide berth. Just do really wide laps around the bridges. Double check and make sure there's no tentacle dudes. I think there is only one, but I might have gotten lucky and snagged the second one with the bombs. Now here, the only thing you really have to worry about on this dude, sometimes he will be a bit cheeky and he'll start shooting his, you know, his acid blobs at you. If he does, just keep an ear out. They have a very, very, very obvious audio cue when he's doing that. Other than that, though, you can just stasis him, you know, hang out by the stasis machines, and you're good to go, really. In hindsight, looking at this run, I mentioned it in the previous chapter, you know, the one downside of not getting the suits is that I'm quite a few upgrades down on stasis. Max stasis, I believe, is 6 shots. You get 6 uses of it per charge, which is really insane when you think about it. The fact that they give you that many. So yeah, I'm just starting the marker moving and we'll pop in a quick save. This next fight, really, really straightforward. We've just got 2 regular necro guys. They do spawn on the goo floor. So just keep that in mind. This guy gives us a vent blade, so, you know, waste not. Might as well use it. And we've got a divider up top. I never tried the contact beam on the divider, and I heard it was quite good on them, so I actually give that a whirl here, and it really is pretty satisfying to use. It just melts them. And it has a really good sound, too. I love the sound effect on the contact beam. It's just really satisfying to use that gun. It kind of defies description, you know. It just tickles my whistle, shall we say. So impale that guy to the wall, because why not? Just watch your step here. I kind of forgot about it and almost got clipped by that first guy on the wall. They don't do a lot of damage, but, you know, would be a rather frustrating way to lose a run like this. So here's the divider, and we shall divide him into several pieces and contact beam him. Again, you know, double, triple tap these guys. Make sure they're dead. I'm not sure if one of the upgrades on the contact beam is ammo consumption is less on the primary fire, because I wasn't really paying much attention to the number there, and yet, you know, when I noticed it, I thought, oh, you know, I've still got kind of, you know, half a mag here after, you know, being overly excessive on shooting him. So when that's one of the things when you've got all the nodes to upgrade. At least for me, I don't really take notice of what the upgrades are. I just kind of hammer through them and just, you know, get every upgrade. Ton of stuff in these lockers. Another thing about not having the upgraded suit is my inventory is a little bit smaller for this segment than is maybe ideal. But again, I mean, I'm kind of going overkill here, really. I think for this segment, all you'd really want, you know, to just blast through it and not even have to worry about anything is probably plasma cutter, contact beam, and force gun. Between that, nothing is going to get through and even get a chance to hit you. You could also use the lime gun, actually, now that I think about it. And, you know, you could put mines up, and that would make it even harder. So here you get a bomb guy and a necro. Just, you know, take a leg off, wait for him to go near him and shoot him. I'm not sure how many tentacles there are here. I could have sworn before I started doing this chapter that you do get 2 more of the giant tentacles here, but I think I only get 1. And I just kind of, you know, keep an ear out for that spawning. You definitely get more than that in the original, and I'd have to go back and check my first run, unless they patched it, but I'm pretty sure you got more than that originally. This guy's weird. It almost looks like he's in stasis, even though, you know, he's not in stasis. But not a whole lot to really talk about here. This is just kind of doing what the plasma cutter does really, really well, and just kind of just zoning them out, really. Fun here with the contact beam. I'm not sure if that knockback is an upgrade either on the contact beam. I'll have to have a proper look at that at some point and you know, see what the upgrades actually do. But I feel like at this point, you know, with how kind of tooled up I am, it's a bit of a there's a slight bit of cruise control here. I'm not too worried about, you know, getting tagged here. So here you get a tentacle guy spawn, and you also get the big tentacle behind you. You can kind of see the giant shadow, makes it nice and easy to know when he's there. Funnily enough, though, I would take out that triple tentacle dude first, because, you know, he can shoot at you, you know, from across the way. We've got a fat dude coming, stasis him and just walk past him. Another example here of, I mean, he's in stasis, so it's even slower, but you can kind of see, you know, just how much time you've got to actually, it's kind of surprising actually, just how much time you have to evade, you know, attacks like that. So here's the other tentacle, and I could have sworn there's supposed to be one on Isaac's right here. So where I am right now, on Isaac's right hand side, in the original, there's definitely another tentacle there, but he never spawns here, so I'm not really sure what's going on. You can actually skip a good chunk of combat here if you want. If you want to start the marker, you know, coming towards the end, then you can just run to the end. I actually found that out by fluke on that no upgrade run, which was quite funny. But you've only got a few enemies here to take out. Again, the mine gun, the line gun, sorry. Although mine gun kind of fits as well. The line gun would be super good here because you could just set up a ton of mines on the bridge. I'm kind of, you know, for once running them on plasma cutter ammo, but I've got, you know, plenty of other ammo for everything else, so might as well. I'm just really just kind of winging it here and having a bit of fun. I think throwing that flame fuel at him actually decapitated him, which was not intentional, but quite funny.
There. Now reunited with the pedestal.
I'm not quite sure how that didn't detonate him. I remember thinking that when I was playing, but I thought, you know, maybe I missed a couple of shots on him. But looking at this back, no, I definitely hit the arm thing there. Yeah, so if you get to this point and hit the switch, it basically just despawns all the enemies. Now, I've sped this up, I think, 400%, and this is still, I think, about 2.5 minutes. This bit is extremely long. When I get to this point, I always end up, I do something, you know, I've got to go make a cup of tea or something. Yeah, this bit's really, really long. And then we're just going to fight the last boss. I'll use this opportunity really to talk about the last boss a little bit. Before I really kind of sat down and studied his the attack where he like shoots the balls at you, like the big acid balls, he was a bit of a concern regarding the single segment run. Now that I've kind of labbed it a little bit, it's really not too bad. As far as I can tell, they don't explode when they come out. It's only if you get near them and when he roars. So all you really need to do is just strafe from one side to the other and just get in front of them, and then you're totally fine, and he won't actually be able to hit you. The last boss, funnily enough, ended up being, I think, probably one of the more consistent bosses, because all you've got to do is be super careful and make sure you go in, you know, armed to the teeth, and you'll be absolutely fine. And this cutscene is still going. But yeah, on the subject of single segment, I'm not going to make any big plans for it now, because as I record this, we've got the RE4 remake in less than a month, so I'm definitely going to be playing that a little bit. I've got one other relatively big project to do before that drops. Hopefully I'll have enough time to do that, and got a couple of other games, you know, to play through for the stream. But by the time you watch this, I'll probably have done at least one of those. So here I'm just selling a few I'm selling a few bits of ammo and that to make a bit of space. Here I actually respec my Ripper, because all those power nodes really are going to waste on the Ripper because I'm not using it. And I'm not going to use it on the boss. So here is, I think, yeah, here is where I fully upgrade my pulse rifle. The reason I do this is because on the last boss, when he grabs you, you know, at the final stage, and he's kind of throwing you around, it can be really tricky to actually land hits on him with, you know, the plasma cutter or any other gun for that matter. Whereas the pulse rifle, fully upgraded, you have such a large magazine, you can just dump bullets on him constantly. And unless you get extremely unlucky, you know, with him moving you, you'll probably kill him, you know, before you die. So, you know, don't quote me on that. But on my on the previous impossible run, it got pretty close. And also on the no damage run, it also felt like it got really close. But I was still able to do it, you know. On the no upgrade run, sorry, not no damage run. And that was with an unupgraded gun. So, you know, if an unupgraded gun can do it, then, you know, fully upgraded is going to be fine. So here we say goodbye to Kendra. Goodbye. There's no dismemberment in this. In the original, Kendra gets messed up real bad. I love how Isaac is just, yeah, bring it. I think that was great. So here, just contact beam his, whatever they're called, boss weak points, for lack of a better word. I'm not sure, if you was to line this up, I do wonder how many you could destroy before he actually does anything, because I got two here without, I wasn't really going to get two, but I missed, you know, I missed my shot there, so I'm wondering, could you actually one-cycle him, you know, by just destroying them. So here, this is the only attack you really need to worry about, but the wind upon it is so long. When he rears back like that, you'll see which tentacle he's going to slam down. So you basically just want to not move. I know it might sound a bit weird, but just don't move. And then as soon as he starts, you know, rearing back, run all the way from the left or the right, or run all the way from the right to the left, you know, depending on what tentacle he's doing. If he's doing the left one, you want to go left to right. If he's doing the right one, you want to go right to left. And you'll virtually never get hit by it, I want to say, because, you know, maybe you might run a little bit too early, you might run a little bit too late, but as long as you, you know, leave it a pretty decent amount of time, you know, those tentacles should not be anywhere near you. That being said, though, don't be too overzealous on it, because they do have a pretty substantial, you know, like, splash damage hitbox. I'd say it's probably about the size of one of the item boxes, so, you know, you want to be as far away from it as you can feasibly, while at the same time, you know, waiting a fair amount of time. It's one of those things where if you try and dodge too early, you try and move out of the way too early, you can get tagged by it. So here, this is why I like having a lot of ammo in the plasma cutter. You can just really zone out everything that spawns here. Just go for the legs, and then when they're on the floor, just, you know, dump a bunch of shots in them. You could also use the pulse rifle for this, if you wanted to. You know, it would do the same job, really. I just figured, you know, I've got the plasma cutter, may as well use it. I know that I kept the force gun just in case, really. So here we are. Here's the final phase where you've got. So here we are. You can see the right tentacle come in, and then just don't move. Left tentacle winds up, and then you run to the left. It's funny how so many of those shots don't actually hit anything, and yet my crosshair is right on. You know, it's right on it. That was kind of strange. Although I did actually test something here. The contact beam is actually great at killing these, you know, boss weak points. Whatever they're supposed to be. His hearts. He has 5 hearts. So here's the only bit that this acid spit. I'm pretty sure this is new. I don't remember that being in the original. But again, it's one of those things. Just don't try and dodge it too early. Wait until he's just about to do it, and then you can see where the line's going to be clearly. And this is probably one of the more trickier parts of this fight, if you was to get, you know, a very narrow point of, you know, where the acid is. And that's why it's important to not, you know, try and dodge it too early, because where that box is right at the back, if he acid puddles, you know, if he does the acid line there and you're on this side, it can actually be very, very tricky to be able to dodge the tentacle slams. But as long as you wait, you should be fine. And there's not a whole lot to talk about here. Kind of like doing Saddler in RE4 on, you know, handgun only or something. Yeah, so as you can see, the contact beam absolutely melts the hearts. We'll call them hearts from now. On. One thing as well you'll notice is where he's actually spitting that acid, it kind of doesn't always line up to, you know, where he actually is spitting it, if that makes sense. Where it lands, rather. You know, where it lands is not always where he, you know, spits. It's kind of weird. They give you so many items in this fight. They do give you quite a few in the original, but I don't think they give you nearly as much as they do in this game. So if you see my health thing flashing green at all, that's just me double-checking that I haven't lost any health, because if you try and use health when you don't need it, the health bar will kind of flash green. If you try and use health when you haven't got any health packs, it will just flash red. Because as I said, sometimes the, you know, the hitbox on those tentacle slams is a lot bigger than you might think. So I'm just kind of really just checking for peace of mind that, you know, I haven't been tagged by anything. Yeah, as you can see, there it is again. I'm just making sure. I think he does. Does he do four? I think he does four. I think he does two of each side, and then, yeah, when he does that, when he kind of reels back, that's when you can get him. So here we go. One thing to note here, make sure your gun, whatever you're going to shoot him with now, make sure it's fully reloaded before you do this. Even though the time on this, as I said, does seem quite generous, but, you know, you don't want to lose a run, you know, like if you're playing Impossible Mode, for example, you know, you don't want to lose a run to something like that. That would be extremely annoying. Yeah, so as you can see there, you know, some of those shots, it just kind of looks like they should be hitting, but I don't know whether the pulse rifle rounds just travel slower than, you know, the plasma cutter maybe. I don't really know about that. I haven't really tested it, but some of those shots just seemed like, you know, they definitely should have been making contact. And there we go, that's it. That's Dead Space Remake. Impossible. No damage. No damage. It was a really fun run to do. I'm not sure what I'm going to do next. It's definitely one of those things where I've got so many ideas for a next run, I'm really not sure where to begin on doing another run. The RE4 style run, I feel like would be good timing, as the remake is coming out. For anyone that's not familiar with that, I think I did it in Dead Space 2. It was an RE4 rule set style run. Basically, you're not allowed to move and shoot at the same time. No stasis, no kinesis, you can't use melee, like, whenever you want. And pretty much just use, you know, play the game as if it was RE4. It's actually really, really fun. And I think that in this game would be quite tricky as well, because any run where you remove kinesis, I think, would make this game, you know, significantly more difficult than it is. Which is, granted, maybe not saying much, but it would be a much tougher challenge with the changes to the stun mechanics. Anyway, guys, that's going to do it for me. I'm going to sign off here. The credits aren't in this because, let's be real, nobody watches the credits, unfortunately. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it was entertaining and maybe informative. Maybe you learned a thing or two. And I will catch you in the next video, whatever that ends up being. Take care. Peace.
It's me. Oh, I wish I could talk to you. I'm sorry.